Hello everyone, this is Sangeeta and welcome to Sayujyam, the Art Zone. Today we will be seeing how to draw the objects in different dimensions using a single vanishing point. I have given a brief introduction on perspective drawing and vanishing points in my previous two videos. I have mentioned them in the I button. You may please watch them later. One point perspective is the simplest of all the kind of perspective methods of drawing. It is called one point perspective because all the lines travel back to a single vanishing point. By now you all know that the horizon line is our eye level. Now I have drawn some squares here, and these four squares are just above and on sides of the vanishing points. Drawing cubes are the simplest way to explain one point perspective. We will connect the corners of these squares to the vanishing point to show them as cubes. You may see two of them are on the horizon line. Take the ruler parallel to this side and draw a line which will show the depth of the cube. Now I have a box where I see two sides. So that means if it is not the front face of your object, then it is going back to the space like this. If you notice, these four cubes here show up with only two sides. Remember, anything that is above or below or on sides of the vanishing point would give you the view of two sides of an object. We can erase all the extra lines to get a perfect cube now. Right now, I am not erasing them all to show them together at the end. Let's talk about an instance where we are going to see three sides of the cube. Now it is going to be at a diagonal position after these sides and not on the horizon line. In this case, we have three corners that are going to meet the vanishing point. Now how do we determine that? We create the converging lines from the corners that are not getting obstructed by the parts of the object. I'll just show it. The fourth corner need not be connected as that line will be hidden behind this cube. At this point, we can go ahead and draw our parallel lines, taking care the ruler remains parallel to this line. Resist the urge to tilt your ruler. It has to be parallel. It could be near or far depending on the depth of the object that you want to show in space. It doesn't matter where you do it within these lines, but the main thing is we should stay in between these two lines. These two lines tell us where the top and bottom of the form are. Okay. Now we have the side and bottom and the front. The bottom is seen because this is above the horizon line and we are looking up at these cubes. Alright, now let's do a shape that is below the horizon line. Again, we are going to draw the converging lines from each of the corners that are unobstructed by the object. Now, we will draw the parallel lines to create the top of the shape. So, remember, anything that is below the vanishing point, we will be looking at it from the top. I know this looks confusing right now. I'll rub all the extra lines and mark them with red color for your understanding. I think now it's more clear. I have marked the converging lines with red for you to understand. Okay, now we will try overlapping these shapes. Let's say I want this box to sit on top of another box. You may try such overlapping of objects to experiment with their positions. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. We will meet in the next video with some interesting drawing using one-point perspective. Till then, take care and bye-bye.